What's up, HF? I'm Omar, and we're back with another action-packed show. Fall sports are all but over, and the winter sports are coming your way. We'll look at all of them on today's Sports Showcase.
Hey guys, I'm Kellen. Before we get into the sports segment of the show, let's take a look who's celebrating a birthday today.
We hope everyone celebrating their birthday today has a great day. Lip Sync 2017 is here, everyone.
What started out as a simple altercation turns into a real sticky situation. Me just thinking on the time that I'm facing makes me wanna cry.
Well, looks like we're ready for Lip Sync, and you should be too. We have great groups ready to perform, and December 11th is approaching quickly.
I'm bored. What do you guys want to do?
Let's play some tunes, man.
I think I have something for you guys.
That was weak. I'm on aux.
A few moments later.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm pretty excited for the show. Make sure to mark your calendars. Our winter sports are here. We got boys and girls basketball, wrestling, and gymnastics that have already started. And today, we preview what these teams have in store for 2018.
With the fall sports season coming to a close, the winter sports season is making its entry. One of the big sports coming up this winter is HF boys basketball. The boys ended their season last year with a 12-8 season and a big win in double overtime against Marion Catholic. This year they're coming in with a very young team, having only four seniors. One of those four, Jonquel Dawson, a transfer student, talks about what he expects this year on the team.
Well, I expect for my team to be good, and I expect for my team to penetrate kick. I expect for me to receive the ball. I expect for my team to be good teammates. Like, when I first came in, I felt welcome, so it's good. I feel like HF a good fit for me.
Leroy Patterson talks about even with having a young team this year, he expects a lot and reflects on HF's season last year.
I expect us to do real good. Even though we're young, we got a lot of talent and we're ready to go. We got a lot of transfers. And then last season, I mean, we did pretty well. We could have made it far. We had injuries.
HF's first game will be their red and white scrimmage today.
Wrestling. The team returns this year after a 3-9 season last year and hope to improve this year. First year head coach Shannon Gillespie takes over the program with high hopes.
potential strengths for this year's Homewood Flossmoor wrestling team is that it's a new start. I am a new coach coming in. My name is Coach Shannon Gillespie, and I hope to bring to this squad some of the motivation and inspiration that was given to me as I was a youth athlete trying to become a state champion. I did become a state high school champion in Illinois, and that's what we have to look forward to this year.
Key returning players like Jeff Griffin can lead the way with their hard work and winning attitude.
As a leader, I'm going to, you know, show that I'm a leader. I'm going to be here and do the things that leaders do. I'm going to make sure my guys are working hard, because that's the number one thing. If you're not working hard in this sport, you're not going to be successful. And as everybody's working hard, we're going to be a successful team. I think we got to run it. We can get a run at state this year.
The team begins their 2018 season on Wednesday, the 22nd of November.
Daily Southtown preseason poll, the HF girls basketball team is ready to make some noise this season. The Vikings, who finished 23-3 last season with a sectional title, returned 5 seniors from last year's team. The Lady Vikings are preparing for yet another strong and successful season.
Our goals this year is to work together as a team and to win state.
Everybody is bringing something different to the table. Everybody has like their own thing they're really good at, and we just come together and it just works out.
Coach Tony Smith knows what he and his team must do this year in order to be successful this season.
Work hard, play hard, dominate, have fun. That's the approach.
The girls are looking forward to yet another dominant season with hopes to win state. From VTV, I'm Malik Perry.
I hope the students will support all of our winter sports as they get their season started. I know I will. The Bone Crusher is here to ask everyone, what was their favorite bone crushing play of the year? Take a look at this to get a clearer picture, and then get ready to vote.
What's up, Vikings? Bone Crusher here for one last time this season. The boys had a great season, finishing off 9-2. Not only have the boys played well all year, but my favorite part? The numerous amounts of bone crushing hits. The Vikings put a hurting on teams all year, but only one player and one play can win the Envy Bone Crusher of the Year award. You may not remember all the bone crushing plays that happened this year, but I do. So let's review. In week one against Michigan City, it was a powerful hit on the running back in the backfield by Mario Wright. In South Carolina on week two, it was Winston Russell. Right after the catch, he put a hit stick on the wide receiver. Next, week three against Stagg, the entire Viking defense won the award for their dominant defensive performance the whole game. In week four, the Vikings faced off against their rivals Bolingbrook, and the Vikings made some great hits, but none better than one from senior Opayemi Fatuki when he slammed the quarterback down for a loss. Week five, the defense had a stellar performance, but one hit told the whole story when Justin Whiteside flung the quarterback to the ground for a loss. Week 7, the Vikings were pitted against Bradley Bourbonnais, and the defense yet again played fantastic. But the highlight of the night was when Isaiah Coe absolutely drilled the quarterback after the pass. In Week 8, the Vikings faced off against the 6-1 Andrew Thunderbolts. But their offense could not compete with the D and a speedy Marcel Ellis, who caught our first pick six of the year to win the award. In week nine, it was the last regular season game for HF as we traveled to Sandburg. Yet again, another dominant defensive performance by the Vikings, but it was all capped off by the D scoring some points from a safety by Savion Harris. Finally, in week 10, the Vikings faced off against Lake Park, and nothing that game was sweeter than the hit Marcel Ellis put on the receiver. I'm pretty sure he was seeing stars after that one. After reviewing the plays, fans, it's your chance to decide who had the most destructive hit of the year. And it's also up to you to vote for who had the bone-crushing play of the year. But you have to do it quick. You only have 1 week to vote. You can find the poll on hffootball.com. You can also find the poll on vikingtelevision.com. And for one last time this year, stay cool, Vikings.
Well, you can cast your vote by going to hffootball.com or our VTV website at vikingtelevision.com. You gotta hurry because every vote counts.
That's gonna do it for the show today. For everyone here at VTV, I'm Kellen.
And I'm Omar. Have a great day, HF.
Have a great day, HF.
Fall sports are all but over, and the winter sports are coming your way. We look at all of this.
That's gonna do it today for the VTV show. For everyone here at VTV.
I hope the students will support our winter sports.